Okay. Okay.
I'm gonna go much smaller.
Pencil. This is serious.
I'm gonna try doing the most nice and flat. Maybe a little more saturation to that blue. But just flat. Keep it as flat as you can. Now I'm gonna go for that mountain color. What do we got there? I like that. Just a gray. In this case, with a little bit of lavender in it. So red, yellow, and blue to make the gray, and then I'll push maybe magenta in that to get the lavender I want. What's nice is if you have a little pencil line and it leaks over it, it's interesting. You get the little line and then you get the little fade. It looks nice. It's a watercolor thing. Okay. I'm going to do, since I did this earlier, I'm going to hit a little bit of this yellow down here really quick for these little. Gonna do that really quick because I know it's behind some things. And I kind of wished on the last one, I wish I would have done this first. Okay. Maybe I'll hit a few of these ends. Might as well just hit it over the whole thing because you won't see 90% of it. Now, great reason not to clean your palette. Just came up with a nice gray. I like that. It's very similar to the one in the background, though. I want it a little bit darker. One of the reasons I don't clean the palette is because it's just red, yellow, and blue on there. And I know I'm probably going to use it in something. Put green in that. Yeah. And you squint your eyes, so much of the shadow on this thing just goes into one big tone. So why don't we just, instead of seeing the pieces and parts, generalize the whole thing. I like the light on the side of that one. A little bit of blue to my shadows. There we go. Just to keep the color varied. There we go. Side of the building, under the eave right there. Whoops. Under the eave. to have filled in this part. That's in shadow. And I just left a little bit of a rimmer on the top. I see a touch of light, a little bit of terracotta up there. I can just sneak it in. Nice little accents. But really, really basic and broad, right? Best way to think of everything is just in holes. I'm gonna throw in a couple of window seals here. They're a little bit darker. If you notice, in general, that tree, most of the shadow is to the inside. Most of the highlights and stuff, the very yellowy lights are on the outside. So that's how I'm going to work this. See, just like that. Leaving it outside, the outside rim is mostly yellow. The inside's mostly dark. Then I can just dry my brush off. There's nothing. Spread the bristles and just dry brush that up into there, like that. It's the magic of watercolor. That's literally what's happening too. There's shadows over those lights. The lights are coming, just like here, the light's coming through the leaves over there. That's why they're glowing. A good time to probably add a few little yeah. Casting shadows. Some red down there too, in the dirt. I forgot to put it in. I'm sorry. Okay, I'll throw it in. There. So I would say, generally, this value could be darker. No problem. I'll just adjust my values. And I don't know why it would seem more violet than that. It is a redder house, isn't it? I'm going to go with a redder gray. Under the eaves there. I'm gonna make that chimney a little bit different. So really moves away from the house here. Add a little bit more water to my paint because it wasn't flowing enough. Wanted to have to really pop away from the background. And I'm going to glaze a little bit of greener gray over this. Actually, I like the way it stands out light. Wait, let's try this. Take your red and smoop it into like this. One of those. And let's start daubing. Daub, 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 daub. There. No? Oh, wow. Was it worth a try? Anyway, what you could do is just come back and smack a little darks in there. Hey, that feels kind of rockish. I certainly could get every little rock in there, knock yourself out. I'll give you an A for the day.
An A?
An A.
How many credits?
I know. How about a tax credit, man? I got killed.
Got killed.
Taxes. Anyway. I'm going to knock down these highlights just a little bit. Although they are pretty darn bright on those shutters. Go for some darks. It's the end of a watercolor, you know. We gotta hit the darks. There's some dark things happening along the roof. Line there. And the window sill. I wanted that orangey glow under here. Keep that first. And come back with these little maybe a little bit of that red or that orangey. Shadows. Our signature.
Nice. Do you want to put any sky reflection in the window glass?
Yeah, I probably should have thought of that earlier.
Sky blue in the window.
I mean, I don't know if I could do it now. Let's see. Yeah, it might work. Depends on how dry it is. You hit it.
Yeah, that's good.
Sometimes what you can do is hit it like that, and then,
you know, oh, that's good.
Yeah. And then come back with your little delightful details.
Good. Very good.
Of course, make sure you get every dark in between one of those stones. Every little stone thing. Yeah. Let's get a nice Altadena morning feel to it. I think it needs, don't you think it needs some greenery back in the back though? Like, back here. And just a faded edge. It wouldn't be any like it. There it is.
I guess it's right.
Yeah. And then I'll take these trees in the foreground.
No.
This painting's already dry. Can you believe it's not oil? Acrylic.
Acrylic, yeah.
I could take this painting and throw it out on Lake Boulevard. People would drive over and it's still, because the acrylic would take it. It would take a bullet. Oh, you know, could you show them the drawing you did?
Oh.
I have it too.
Maybe
I should turn the light on.
Looks like it,
Brad. Just the strokes themselves are
right
really
there,
doing.
Behind you. My card, right there.
And all this down here, look at that. That's almost, I mean, you could take that off. That corner right there reads as a piece of abstract expressionism. Look at that. Right there. Look at this. So he's really maintaining all of the freshness of the stroke and still grasping all the reality of the and dimensionality of the reality of the anything else that ends in ality.
Building ality.
Sorry. What was that?
Building ality.
Yeah. The building
build the spirit of it.
Build ality. Sorry. It's yeah, wonderful.
Thank you.
Also, I never saw the face on that house, but there's a face there.
Oh, I didn't see that either.
Yeah.
Nose and eyes.
Exactly.
I didn't either. Now that you mention it.